One of the most remarkable technological achievements in the 20th century was the 1969 moon landing, when NASA successfully sent Apollo 11 to the moon and Neil Armstrong famously took one small step for man and one giant leap for mankind. But how would history have panned out differently if this monumental event never took place? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if America never went to the moon? Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content. For this video, we're exploring the alternate timelines that might have happened had Apollo 11 never launched and the Eagle never landed. There have been various theories over the years that America never did go to the moon, that it was faked, but those are for another video. The moon landing was, in many ways, the culmination of 2 decades worth of tension between the world's superpower, the United States and the Soviet Union. The space race began in the 1950s, partly as a way to publicly show off the increasingly large rockets that both nations were making for the nuclear arms race. In July 1955, America announced they were going to launch a satellite, and the Soviets retaliated just 4 days later by saying they would do it first. Ultimately, it was the Soviets who won this milestone, launching Sputnik in late 1957. And after that, the USSR achieved practically every other milestone first, too. Sending the first animal into orbit, Laika the dog, the first man into space, Yuri Gagarin, and the first woman into space, Valentina Tereshkova. Nevertheless, it was in the midst of all these rival successes that JFK made one of America's most famous speeches. In 1962, despite lagging behind the Soviets, Kennedy announced that America would make it to the moon by the end of the 1960s, not because it was easy, but because it was hard. With Kennedy's assassination happening just a year later, achieving this became paramount not only to winning the space race, but to upholding his legacy. If Kennedy's death impacted America's plans, though, then the death of Sergei Korolev, a chief engineer in the Soviet space program, impacted Russia's probably even more so. It was Korolev who had been the driving force behind most Soviet space initiatives. But he died in 1966, and the USSR lost its lead over the US without him. With our alternate history beginning in 1969, with the moon landing that in this case didn't happen, there's no way for Korolev's death to be averted. So even if America had failed to go to the moon, it's perhaps unlikely Russia, which still has never sent a cosmonaut in the decades since, would have gone in their stead. If America doesn't go in 1969 then, potentially nobody would ever have gone. It's not like the encompassing Cold War would necessarily have stopped as well, though. It had been bubbling since the late 1940s, before the space race proper, and it continued to some degree up until the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991. So not going to the moon wouldn't likely have stopped America, or the Soviets, from continuing to develop giant rockets. It would have just sent both countries along a different path. Perhaps in an alternate history, something would have specifically happened to block the space race, or divert attention away from it, like a high-profile space travel disaster. But in truth, there have been many fatal accidents and mistakes in the history of space travel, and there were various incidents before Apollo 11, so we've already seen how getting to the moon was not without human cost, but how governments have been prepared to carry on regardless. As the moon mission became such a huge part of American culture in the 1960s, however, what's perhaps more likely is that NASA would have simply ran out of time. As it is, Apollo 11 landed on the lunar surface with just 5 short months to spare in terms of achieving JFK's original remit to get there within the decade. Had America not gone to the moon in the 60s, then public interest may well have flagged, and NASA's state funding almost certainly would have dropped. The Nixon and Ford administrations would have been faced with balancing incredibly costly and ambitious missions with a general lack of return for the investment. Even today, analysts debate whether there's any profit at all to be made out of going to the moon. Yes, there are many useful resources up there, including hydrogen and aluminum, but the prospect of getting there again and setting up a viable mining operation requires billions and billions of government dollars. Even as history was with a successful moon landing, the Apollo program was canceled just 3 years later, and NASA's funding was slashed to less than 1% of the federal budget by 1975. If America had never gone to the moon, then those cuts might have happened even sooner, and even more severely. That's not to say that space would have been closed for good, only that the international approach would have unfolded differently. Perhaps we'd have seen the emergence of private space firms sooner, for example, but we'd certainly have seen a general tightening of the belt across the industry. History shows that we really did see a more cost-effective method of space exploration take hold in the 1970s, with a focus on uncrewed lunar rovers. Again, though, the USSR was marginally ahead of the trend. While America sent more and more people to the moon up until 1972, the Soviets backtracked and began sending robots, the first of which to land on the lunar surface was the Lunokhod 1, landing in November 1970. Had a human moon landing never happened, the age of robotic and remote space exploration may have emerged sooner and with greater gusto. We might never have seen the shuttle program as it was, for example, as the want to put humans in space may not have developed at the same rate. We may not have gotten the International Space Station so soon either for the same reason. Although far-off machines arguably don't offer the same space romanticism as manned missions, they're certainly safer and cheaper to operate, and they can run indefinitely, as the Voyager probes continually prove. Maybe then, without space stealing so many of the headlines, we'd have seen more major breakthroughs in other scientific fields, fields which captured public and official interest even more so than space travel did. Ending the Apollo program early would at least have freed up the federal budget for other things, and while it's impossible to say, it could have fast-tracked us toward a better and quicker understanding of things like quantum physics, disease prevention, or environmental issues, all of which are major scientific priorities today. Of course, the excess money might have also been funneled into more nuclear weapons development for the Cold War. But this actually wouldn't have been in line with many of Nixon's détente policies, aiming to ease tensions with the USSR, so maybe not. Instead, Nixon might have pledged the cash that would have been NASA's toward domestic policies and welfare reforms, or the agency's budget cut could have gone to further fund more controversial endeavors like the ongoing Vietnam War or the war on drugs. Even today, when the percentage government spend on NASA is considerably lower than it was in the 60s, there are plenty who argue that we're still spending too much, that the money we use on space could be better used tackling many other problems here on Earth. But regardless of how and where in this alternate history the money saved on the Apollo program did go, we'd clearly be missing a major cultural event. Though it was America who went to the moon, as Armstrong said, the feat represented a giant leap for all of mankind. And it was something that felt like all of mankind was tuned in for. Coverage of the moon landing broke all sorts of records at the time and, for a while, was the most watched television broadcast in history, with more than 600 million viewers, around one-fifth of the global population when it happened. So, if nothing else, if the moon landing never took place, then we'd never have had that collective experience. We surely would have saved some money and perhaps even some lives, but we'd be missing a cultural touchstone like no other, a reminder of what humans are capable of when we're allowed to thrive. And that's what would have happened if America never went to the moon.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.